All right, so as you guys know that I love my meat soft, tender, mellow, and very, very, very well done. Not like so much of the mediumness to it, but I love it really well done. And we are that kind. This is why we love this, is it? This is why we love this show. This is why we've had all the episodes that we have run through over the month. And today I'm here in Naguru to again take you guys on a journey, loving everything about this place right here. Now I've been told that these guys have the best of what you can want for lunch. Now it's a bit sunny, as you can see. We had a little bit of shower raining down, but it's still good to go with the food. So I am at Miha. Check this out. These guys are called Miha. They have Grill House and Pizzeria. That means we are going to have lots of grills and a little bit of pizza being sold in here. But I don't know what the chef has for us today. So let's go in and check out what they have. My name is Chef Aaron. Food, super excited to eat up. So let's go in and check this out. Baby food. All right, so we are at Miha, and what I want to tell you guys is in the past episodes we have done, you've seen amazing food. You are going to have a mind blow up of what's in Miha. Now as I get to see the chef do his thing, I'm just gonna walk in there and have a chat. Let's go. Follow me. Busy, and I like how busy is it. This is exactly what I'm talking about. Having this going on here, right in here, it's majestic. Literally sits in there and everyone rackets. Feels so lethal, busy as it is, yeah. But when these guys get orders, this is what happens.
Some ketchup. Boss.
Yo, chef.
Assalamu alaikum.
I don't know what to salam
means,
to that
means
too,
but... to with you, my man.
All right, peace, man.
I am multilingual.
All right, so what are you guys doing? I see you guys running off. Looks like a Tom and Jerry in here.
You know, it's just,
what's
it's
going
just
on?
Lunch service.
You have an order?
We have a couple of orders running.
Okay.
Then you also want to eat some good food.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah. I'm here for some good racket live.
I need to get you sorted.
Give me something that's going to stir up my guest, because she has been thinking about Miha for a pretty long time. Pretty long time. She literally took a night's fast for this visit, so I'm thinking it's going to be worth it.
That's interesting. Yeah, we're going to give you a standard three course. We do multi-course meal.
Okay.
I'm going to give you a...
Look
a,
at
a
you go first. Did you cut your fingers with that? That is super genius, man. Super genius. I should have the guests try this out.
The knives are like razor.
Bring her in the kitchen and try this out. Whoa.
So I want them really, really, really finely chopped.
Okay.
So,
what order do we have now that we're working on?
Now, this is your order.
Okay.
I'm giving you a starter. All
right.
And a main. The main is a platter.
Okay.
We are a grill house.
Okay.
We do loads of meats. We do burgers, we do pizza, we do steak, we do fish, we do crocodile.
Okay.
But today I'm giving you a standard platter, a three meat platter with chicken, pork, and beef.
Yeah. So I've had a little bit of that in our past episodes. If you guys were with me at Rider's Lounge, we had a platter at Rider's Lounge, and that's exactly what they gave us. We had crazy ribs. I mean, buttery and mellow as they were, very juicy and tender. Now I'm so excited to see what chef is going to give us as he cuts and chops those little fellas out there. That's how the guest wants them, really tiny and small. She's a very tiny person, so that's going to be exciting. So anyways, as chef gets busy and runs up and down, chef, is that an onion?
Katungulu.
Katungulu.
Olava tuli bazungu wano to come made nunje.
So is it okay to have to eat fresh onion as it is?
Yeah, it's lovely.
It's okay, it's fine. Gets into a salad.
If you have arthritis.
Sorry?
If you have arthritis.
Arthritis?
Arthritis. It's a bone disease.
Yeah.
You recommend onion as your remedy.
There you go, people. some little bit of food science in there with the chef. Okay, so if you have that, that's what you go for. So many of you guys have lots of onions in your pantries at home. I think that's one of the things I love to have in my kitchen. Give me a little bit of onion, a little bit of garlic, and I'm away to go with a classic meal for the day. So
I'm starting out your starter.
Okay, so that's the starter.
Yeah.
Nice, lovely. I love how small the plates are. Good detail. I mean, looks like a baby's plate, but nice for a starter, right?
Yeah, perfect for starter.
Yeah, perfect for a starter. I mean, this is just the right portioned plate really size good, really. That would come in for a starter. So yeah. All right, there you go. All right, so what's that? Is that ice cream?
Well, this is Thousand Islands.
Okay, that's a dressing, so to speak. Yeah, so it's garnishing the plates already. And I think this looks beautiful. It's gorgeous. That's simple, and the chef gets it done. So, I mean, these are some of the techniques we get to do when we're, you know, sitting down for a fine dining restaurant experience. I told you guys do fine dining here as well?
Yes, we do. We do fine dining on order.
All right.
It's something that we love to show off.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'm doing
the... Police!
What?
Come for him.
What happened? Bro, you were talking about fine dining. You do fine dining here as well?
We do fine dining.
Okay.
One of our strengths. Mm-hmm. We're a very simple restaurant, but we do good food. We do amazing food.
Okay. So does it happen like a chain service fine dining experience?
Yes, we do that once a month.
Okay. Oh, you do that once a month.
Once a month. Yeah, you come in, sit down, you impress somebody.
Okay.
You boys, sorry, we're both married.
Okay.
But you're like a young girl you want to impress, you bring her over.
A young girl you want to impress.
Mm. Keyword, young girl.
Young girl. Bro, so the thing about fine dining is that it comes with a style of dressing, style of dining, everything gets in there a bit different. Yeah. So do you also do it the same way at Miha?
No, it's very casual.
Is it? It's casual.
Very casual fine
so
dining.
So I can come in with my jeans.
Yeah, jeans, sneakers, shorts.
Patras.
As long as you're dressed.
As long as you're dressed. Yeah. So, as long as you're dressed, you can get down here at Miha in Naguru and enjoy a one-off in a month?
Once a month, yeah.
One-off a month.
What I'm doing, I'm going to toast these a bit. Give them some crunch and taste.
Yeah.
I use margarine.
Okay.
I use butter, but why? It's too expensive for you. You don't deserve it.
Wow.
What did
Wow. Wow. You just shot me there with a glass of wine. Ha! This so is so dry, so I'm just going to get soda for it, man.
We grill all our meats.
I don't do soda.
Yeah, we grill our meat.
So if a guest wants it a little more crispy than it is there, the request for it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Remember, this is an ambush bush. It's complimentary.
Okay, yeah.
So it's different every day.
Yeah, sure.
If you're doing something like that, impress you.
Yeah.
We have a grill, sadly you can't bring cameras, we have a grill down here.
Yeah.
All our meats are grilled, we don't fry, we don't boil.
No, it's a house of grill. Perfect. So, it's making us an amuse-bouche. I mean, amuse-bouche is a mouth amuser. It's something that will excite you before you actually get your starter coming through. This is super fine dining. Super fine dining. I'm just going to make sure I reduce most of his mise en place. Because I need to get this going, man. Bro, need to get this going. So anyways, my guest is almost here. I just need to go out there and wait out for her. So as you get going, let me just step out and meet her. All right. Okay. Yeah. All right, just do your thing. Let me bowl out and then see you later, bro. The trick that we usually put on the table with our guests, we bring in something quite simple. Now, in the previous episode, we had gorillas, okay, on the table. We had a silverback, and I had the silverback, definitely. And the guest over here had the baby gorilla. So today we have the salt. So as our guest comes in, let's play that game. Hey!
Hello!
Hey. Hi! Good to see you. I need a pug. Good to have you, Diana.
Good to have you, too.
Please have your seat. Whoa. I've been waiting, the chef has been cooking.
A lot of jam.
Tuba down a trebles. What time will she be here?
I'm here, finally.
Finally, you're here. Your seat is out of Can I get you a little in closer to the table? Yeah, just a little bit there. Oh, there you go.
Thank you.
And then I shall push this table right in there.
Thank you. Hey, how are you?
Very comfy. I'm good. I'm good.
Hey, this?
You want this closer?
Yeah.
There we go.
All right. Thank you.
Okay. Do you want the table too?
No. Thank you.
Nice. Okay. Good
how
to have you on the show.
Thank
how are you doing? How was your journey?
Good.
Was it easy to find the place?
Well, a lot of traffic.
Oh,
and,
nice.
You know, I thought I would be here by early by 10 minutes.
Well, you're here on time. You're here on time. Okay, so this is it. This is the show. We are going to review some of
this
what
is it.
Miha has.
Mm-hmm.
I know you've watched the show, have you?
Yeah, so much.
And you've loved it?
And I'm lucky to sit with a celebrity.
Vako, minister.
Celeb of the day.
Come on. Yeah. So, we at Miha,
mm-hmm.
and you're looking lovely.
Thank you.
What's with the red?
Love.
Color of love.
Love for food, love for what I do.
Love for the meal. The chef is here with the starter.
Hello.
Chef, what do
Thank
we have
you.
Right here?
Virginia costini.
Okay.
Bacon and vegetable costini.
Whoa.
Some bujogolo and the bread.
Nice. Looks lovely. Whoa. Looks lovely. Should we start digging in?
Enjoy.
Amazing. Now, one thing I love about Miha is that they bring in little details, almost like baby's food.
I know.
But I know it's going to turn out amazing. This is an amuse bouche. I saw the chef racket down all the ingredients that we see on the bread. It's the bread, we have the sauce, we have that garnish right there. Buno, what you taught here?
Great.
In your own understanding?
Buno, in my design.
Design,
even
yeah. Okay, before we dig in, I have a very simple game that I put to people on the table. Mm. Every time I eat with them.
Mm. Excuse
you,
me?
You have something?
Mm-hmm.
You can put it right here.
No, thank you.
I used to have my school teacher do that. Bring the gum, put it here.
Mm-hmm.
Right here. But anyway, that was a joke.
Yeah,
so I was telling you about a trick, a table trick I usually pull out,
mm-hmm.
okay? I know how salt gets to wet the mouth.
Mm.
So usually when I'm waiting for the food, I just do that. Get a rock of salt out and just eat it. You want to try it out?
Okay.
I'm going to tell you what it does once you try out with the salt.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
What does that do?
It makes your mouth wet.
Yeah, it wets the mouth, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now we can eat.
Enough
of the salt.
Are you being serious, Wayne?
Enough of the salt. Okay,
you
right in there.
My mind?
So in here, it's an amuse bouche. We have a little bit of bacon, like the chef said.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit of bacon, a little bit of that vegetable in there. I think it looks like a bush of vegetable, but nicely diced, okay? Sat on that very tiny piece of bread. So let's test this guy as small as it is. Ready for it?
Mm-hmm.
Let's dig it. Nangalo. In we go.
Mm.
Mm.
Nice.
Yeah. Pretty. Absolutely pretty. It's a nice mouthfeel. Mm. Little bit of that sauce. It's not just a garnish. Is that falling? Mm.
Let me try this as well.
Yum. Mmm. I'm in love with the bacon. Love it.
Nice.
This is amazing. So, what did you think?
Very nice.
Okay.
You know, when I first saw it,
mm-hmm.
I looked at the bread and I was like, okay, now this is bread with kachumbari.
Yeah, bread
yeah.
with kachumbari, yeah? With small pieces of kachumbari on.
And then some designs on
That's
the plate.
That's a good observation. I didn't see it that way.
Mm-hmm.
But it is a good one. All right?
Yeah, but it's amazing.
Okay. With the sauce?
Yeah.
Okay.
Tastes so well.
Okay. It's perfectly seasoned.
Mm-hmm.
Has the right acidity,
mm-hmm.
and there's something at the back of the tongue that feels like chili, but it's not chili.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's
but
the paper.
I think
paper.
This is the paper, yeah.
Yeah, it's the paper.
Mm.
Yes, both the black paper, but I missed mine. Let me just, more for you.
Seriously?
More for you.
Okay, let me give this some as well.
Come on, you can't be that generous
Big
when
heart.
I'm being It's red, color of love.
Mm. Please.
Right in there. Okay, so as we wait out for the next course with the chef, you have a show on Spirit TV. And
oh, yes.
I love what you do.
Thank you.
Tell me about it.
Well, it's an inspirational show,
okay.
transformational.
Yeah.
We do health,
mm-hmm.
We do lifestyle,
yeah.
we do relationships.
How come you don't do food? Why?
Well, You do food, so...
I mean, get us in there and let's have some food. Chef is here.
We can't all be doing food.
Awesome. Yeah. That is the reaction you get in Miha.
Mm.
Whoa. Big heart.
This looks yummy.
Chef, what do we have right here? Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, I know. I can tell.
Say that again. Say it again, because I need to take a mark on that. Say it again. The chicken is out of this world.
Whoa.
Did he just say that? Okay. So as fast as I know, I think
this
the presentation looks
amazing. Now this is
amazing.
When the you know, the mouth gets wetter.
It's wetter. Before it wasn't wet.
Mm-hmm.
The engine was started. All right,
now
cool.
It gets wetter.
Okay, so what's your take about meats? When it gets to meats, what's your one thing that gets you off a platter, gets you started to eat?